Hey, welcome back once again, everyone. My name is Prestige. Thank you for joining me. This is episode number 31 of a series that I like to call Elite Weapons of Advanced Warfare. In this series, we take a look at elite variations of weapons you'll find in your supply drop while playing through Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I let you know whether or not those weapons are worth keeping or scrapping for the 2000 XP. If you happen to miss any of the other 30 episodes, you can find a complete playlist linked down below in the description and in the form of a card, which you can find on your screen right now. But without further ado, let us get into today's video, and this is the one, the only, the MP11 Goliath. This is a very good alternative to the speakeasy if you're not one to use the speakeasy, if you really don't want to use the ASM1 at all. This is a great alternative. However, I will say this, you will never be able to get a three-shot kill unless your enemy is already hurt. If you're going up against somebody that already has full health, that has never been damaged, it's going to take you at minimum four shots, and we'll talk about that in just a moment, but let's start with the bad of this weapon. It's not that bad, but it is something that you will notice right away. The handling is decreased by 3. Now, what handling is going to do for some machine guns is it's going to widen your hip fire spread. It's going to make it a little bit harder to hip fire. So what I would suggest is putting on the laser sight to correct that, like you see in this gameplay. The laser will not bring it back down to what the base version of the MP11 is, but it will, however, add an additional 20% on there, basically bringing it to only minus 10% handling, which is something that is great to have. You don't have to worry too much about that, and it does help you if you 100% absolutely need to hip fire the enemy that's directly in front of you. Now, moving over to the bonuses or the benefits to this weapon, you have a plus 3 to your damage. So like I was saying earlier, even with this damage increase, it's still going to take you at minimum 4 shots. However, that 4 shot kill range is increased. You're going to notice that you're going to be getting 4 to 5 shot kills, which is a lot better than the base version of the MP11. This is the most powerful MP11 variant that you can get as of right now, so if you end up getting this thing, I would 100% just keep it. I mean, that's my early determination of this weapon. If you're somebody that doesn't like to rock the ASM1 all the time, if you're somebody that likes to switch up your game and use different weapons, different variations of weapons, if you like the MP11, you're going to absolutely love this weapon right here. So let's talk about the class setup. I'm going to go ahead and put it on the screen for you really quick. That's one more thing that I want to note, is there is no attachment restrictions on this weapon, so you can use rapid fire if you want to. You can go ahead and put on a foregrip to have even more control over your recoil. Hell, you can even put on an optical like a red dot sight and have that for added accuracy if you really need to. However, the class setup that I have on the screen right now is the one that I like to use personally. I got the advanced rifling on there to increase my overall 4-shot kill range. I have extended magazines on there because the rate of fire for this weapon is already very, very high. And then I have the laser on there just to increase my overall hip fire accuracy because of that decrease in handling. Now, on the perk side of things, that pretty much comes down to how you're feeling. So let me tell you how I feel about this weapon. This is a straight up run and gun weapon. You want to be as close as humanly possible. You want to make sure that you're constantly faking out your enemies, making them think you're in different areas, and you want to make sure you know where your enemies are. So running score streaks like UAVs and stuff, you can definitely do that, but you won't always get them. However, I found using the overcharge perk with XO ping makes it a little bit easier to find out where your enemies are, especially if you are running and gunning and you are going kind of tunnel vision, not knowing where your enemies are. This helps you find them a little bit easier, as long as they're not using the perks to kind of negate the effect. So pretty much what I like is this XO ping, because it's like a portable VSAT, and you're basically able to see anybody that's in your vicinity using an XO movement, shooting their weapon, and so on and so forth. It just paints them red. It's awesome, and I'm kind of surprised I don't see more people use it. And then moving down the list, normally I like to use toughness with anything I use in core game modes, just because the flinch is a little bit high. However, I will say this, and I don't know why, I like to run scavenger just so I have the extra ammo, because this weapon does shoot very, very quickly. But one thing that I did notice is even when I'm aiming down sights and I end up getting shot back at, the weapon actually bounces back up and it gives me easier headshots. So the headshot multiplier is going to help you get easy kills. It's also going to help you get a lot more kills in the long run. So think about how you want to set it up your way. Perks are basically down to how you're feeling. This is a very versatile weapon in pretty much any game mode you play. It's great for search and destroy as well. Even with the suppressor, you're going to do very, very well. But try out XO ping. It's one of those XO abilities that you don't see much of in game. It lasts a little bit longer with the XO overcharge, and if you really feel like you're going to be running and gunning like you see in this gameplay, it's definitely going to help you get those super easy kills, especially if people aren't running the perks to negate the effect, like I said before. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Elite Weapons of Advanced Warfare. If you did, make sure to click that thumbs up button down below, and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Do not get rid of this weapon. I'm telling you guys, It's not worth the scrap. This is the best MP11 variant out there, and it's great. It's great. So I hope you guys get it. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.